And I guess that I found that if I can bring some lightness to the things that I'm talking about, it becomes something that you can talk about. Mm-hmm. So.
I agree 100%.
Yay!
So. I said this is part movie review, part public service announcement, part autobiography. So, I'd like to talk about my pelvic floor. You guessed it, hardcore comedy. Let me start by saying that I didn't know there was a medical term for when you leak, when laughing, sneezing, coughing, or trampolining. Because I grew up watching my mom cross her thighs when she sneezed. I thought it was something that all older women do.
I do.
So during a recent physical exam, my doctor asked me if I had any concerns. I decided to bring up the leaking, which had become especially notable since delivering my baby. Kegels, or my attempts at them, had proven ineffective. The doctor said it sounded like stress incontinence, and he referred me to a urologist to find out more. Stress incontinence? It was more than a vague, culturally invisible, endemic female condition. There was a name. That meant there must be ways of dealing with it. It gave me hope for a future where I can endure bronchitis without wetting myself. When I met the urologist, he was a short man with a short, thick neck, so much so that he wasn't able to turn his head without turning his torso. I told him about the leaking and about my interest in working with my body proactively. He said, "We could do surgery, but I wouldn't suggest it until later." I asked if there might be something physiological underlying the condition, since my mom had dealt with similar but more severe issues. Maybe, but no easy way of knowing. And what if I'm just not doing Kegels correctly? "Kegels won't correct the problem, they just delay the deterioration," he said. I asked him where I could go to do my own research, and he handed me a brochure titled, "What You Need to Know About Stress Incontinence," produced by a company that manufactures bladder slings, pessers, and other incontinence aids. I was feeling discouraged about the entire situation when I got a phone call from my friend Beth, who asked, "Have you ever seen 50 Shades of Grey?" Now, I'm not a big movie watcher, so it wasn't surprising to her that I hadn't. Besides the fact that it got terrible reviews, was described as mainstream porn, and generally denounced as pre-feminist, I'm busy. Still, Beth insisted, with a breathlessness to her voice, that I watch it so we could talk about it. So I did, despite my reading at least a dozen more negative reviews. I watched the movie and was really impressed then by the beauty of the film, the soundtrack, the cinematography, and the uncharacteristic psychological maturities with which the characters navigated sex. This new couple was explicitly negotiating the terms of playing dominant and submissive roles with each other, and in doing so, talked openly and plainly about exploring the edges of pleasurable, consensual sex. I found her to be strong, able to set boundaries, and be decisive about what she did and didn't want. I found him to be straightforward, respectful, and able to exercise a high degree of mutuality. This was the movie where people raged against the abusive acts and power imbalance portrayed, and I was watching not the dance of model characters, but ones who were thoughtful, intimate, sensual, and with scenes that were, dare I say, erotic. Well, after I watched the first movie, Beth and I had a long conversation about the surprising and revelatory experience of viewing a film that portrays desire and arousal from a vagina-centered perspective. The next time I saw her, Beth insisted that I watch the second movie, 50 Shades Darker. Now, I have a 4.5-year-old, and frankly, my erotic movie viewing time is limited. But one night, after I'd gotten my daughter to sleep, I found time. There is a scene in the second movie where Christian suggests, and Anna agrees, to having two metal, gumball-sized beads inserted into her vagina. And after that, it's clear in the way she holds herself that the bowls have a resonant quality that create high-level stimulation. Now, you know that after the movie was over, I, like many women, I suspect, looked up exactly what those bowls were.
Benoit.
Yeah. Benoit sister.
It turns out they are Benoit balls.
We know why you were.
And precursor to Kegel balls. I learned that when Benoit balls are inserted, they cause the vaginal muscles to grip and engage, and toning the pelvic muscles themselves through the exercise of gripping contributes to the pleasure of the woman and the person inside her. I also learned that practice prevents and treats stress incontinence, a condition faced by at least 30% of women under 60. It turned out that Googling Kegel balls yielded a considerable amount of new information. Lovehoney.com has a video about not to be confused with Honey Love, which is for urban beekeepers. So they have a video about the benefits of having strong pelvic floor muscles. It increases arousal, strengthens orgasms, and tones muscles for better bladder control. Feeling frustrated, I texted Beth. Why haven't you already bought Benoit balls? You saw this movie a week ago. Beth, I'm researching as we speak. Me, I'm angry my urologist didn't tell me about them last spring. That would have produced a pleasurable therapeutic experience. Effing anti-pleasure culture. Beth, I'm dying. Me, what's more, the doctor's office sent me a survey to gauge my satisfaction with the practice, and I'm tempted to send them a link to the Livestrong article I found about Benoit balls, along with a lecture on the subjugation of women. Beth, Amy watches 50 Shades of Grey and demands justice. Me, why don't my doctors know how to tend to a pelvic floor, for Christ's sake? Beth, I'm currently checking out Inner Goddess Silver Pleasure Balls. 7.8 ounces. That seems heavy. Me. I see you could do the silver jingle balls. 2 ounces. Ho, ho, ho. Apparently, they've been well received. Beth. I can't even type. I'm laughing so hard. Me. Why am I getting more and better clinical information about bladder health at an online sex toy store than from my fucking urologist? Why am I getting leads on my gynecological health from 50 Shades of Grey more than I am from my medical doctor? Well, since Harvey Weinstein, we all know why. We live in a world that is upside down, inside out, and backwards, and it is crumbling apart as we speak. And it is about damn time. Men, don't be alarmed. When we get done being pissed off, we're gonna fix shit. And ladies, for Christ's sake, take care of your pussies. I mean, your orgasms. I mean, your pelvic floors.
Amen.
Yeah.